Siempre. Good morning, third grade. Okay, third grade, listen to me, guys. Everybody pay attention. If you remember, we are talking about the date. We are recognizing the month of the years. For example, the month of the years are January, February, March, April, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December. And we're recognizing too that date, different dates of the month. And now you can say your birthday, for example. When is your birthday? Oh, my birthday is on July 15th, or July 7th, or July 2nd, or July 3rd, or July 1st, I don't know. And now you can say your date or your birthday. When is your birthday, or when is your mother's birthday? Something like that. Entonces, de eso se trata esta unidad, de reconocer todo lo que son los meses del año y la fecha. Let's continue. What date is it? What date is it? You need to be clear in this part because maybe I ask you, what date is today? What day, no date, right? It's different. What day is today? Oh, today is Wednesday. Today is Thursday. Today is Monday, Saturday, Sunday, Friday. All right, what day is today? Today is Friday, 2nd. Today is Saturday 7th. And now you recognize the date is different and the day, all right? And now we're learning what date is it. We are identifying, we are recognizing all the dates, the day, the month, the years, and different days. And now open your workbook on page number 47. Open your workbook on page number 47. Okay, on the page number 47, we are going to make sentence using the correct way to make a sentence. For example, number one, it say here, no, it's number one in that part. What day it is? What day it is? What day it is not is incorrect, all right? Because you never say what day it is. The correct way you ask the day it is, what day it is today? What day it is today? Oh, today is Friday. Or today is Wednesday, 27th July 2021 or 2021. Okay, what date is today or what date is it is the correct way. Okay, Itamar, tell me.
No podemos iniciar la primera donde dice Henry.
All right, wait a moment. Number two, Henry's birthday, November 3rd. Itamar?
Henry Binder, November.
Very good. Third, for example, he say Henry is a name. Listen to me. Henry is a name, but if you look here in that part, Henry is using apostrophe. Apostrophe is something like that because you need to recognize that that is on, is on. Okay, is there, is his. Es algo posesivo, is possessive. Es algo posesivo para él y por lo tanto, eso le pertenece a él. Nadie se lo puede quitar. Por eso se pone ese apóstrofe, o en inglés apóstrofe, in that part because you need to recognize who is that, o who is he, o qué es de él, pues qué es lo que le pertenece a él. Por eso dice ahí Henry's birthday, o sea, el cumpleaños de él, solamente de nadie más. Estamos en el workbook page 47. All right, ajá. Henry's birthday. Voy a poner también el apóstrofe. Birthday is on or in November. Ahí no dice ninguna de las dos. Third. Creo que ahí va más in. Is in November. Porque le pertenece. Henry's birthday is in November 3rd. And now, Mother's Day, second Sunday, May. What is the correct sentence? Tell me, guys. Diana.
Mother's Day is the second Sunday of month.
Thank you so much. Mother's Day, we have another apostrophe here. Mother's, no, it's mother, mother's. Mother's Day is of second Sunday, oh, in my useful of May. Very good. Number three, how many days April? What is the correct question? How many days April? All right, déjame ver si hay otra mano por acá. Very good, Itamar and Diana. Itamar, tell me.
How many days April?
Or how many, thank you, days there are. How many is there, how many days, sorry, no day. How many is there are in April? How many is they are in April? How many is they are in April? Vamos a ponerle there are. On April, on April. ¿Cuántos meses, cuántos días hay en abril? Number three, four, Diana. There are 30 days.
Young. There are days in
or on you. Very good. There are 30 days in June. Solamente hay 30 días en junio. All right, guys. But remember, don't forget the apostrophes here because the apostrophe recognize or maybe show us the possession of the people of a person, of a person. For example, I could say, Arlette Charnels, right? Arlette Charnels. O sea, que este sacapunta me pertenece a mí, no a otra persona. ¿Sí me entiende? Entonces, por ello, es que siempre se utiliza el apóstrofe que ustedes ven aquí arriba. La comita esa se le llama apóstrofe. En español y en inglés, apóstrofe. Right? And you need to recognize the apostrophe here. Okay, guys. All right, let's continue, guys. Vamos a continuar, señores. Okay, everybody. All right, and now we are going to complete the Chora dialogue. Okay, the rabbit and the turtle, they are talking about different dates. For example, the rabbit says, where do you want to go on Sunday? The turtle answer, I want to go mountain climbing. All right, and the correct question is, what date is today? What date is today? What date is today? Oh, it is May 12th because we have a calendar here and it's May. It's May 12th. It is Mother's Day. It is on the second date of May. It is on the second day of May, remember? Right, I almost forgot. We can take our moms to go mountain climbing. Mountain oh my god all right Repeat, where do you want to go on Sunday? I want to go mountain climbing. What date is today? It is May 12th. It's Mother's Day. It is on the second date of May, remember? Right, I almost forgot. We can take our moms to go mountain climbing with us. Great idea. All right. ¿A dónde tú quieres ir el domingo? Me gustaría ir a escalar las montañas. ¿Qué día es hoy? Hoy es 12 de mayo. Es el Día de las Madres. Es el segundo día del mes de mayo, ¿recuerda? Ah, es cierto, casi lo olvido. Bueno, podemos llevar a nuestra mamá a escalar la montaña con nosotros. Great idea. Right, it's so easy. We are going to recognize them the date of the week. The man of the year. And thank you so much for today.